Hello, I'm Sandeep, the creator of ReRead, the self-hosted RSS reader. The motivation to participate came from the chance to learn and experiment with the Redis modules. I've experienced using Redis as a cache, but never had the chance to explore the Redis modules. The reason I picked to develop an RSS reader is because I already subscribe to over 500 feeds, shelling out dollars every month. Still, there are features that are not available unless I pay more. For example, Feedly, InnoReader, NewsBlur, FeedSpot, and Winds are already limited in their functionality. Following Redis modules were used to build this application. Redis Core for caching and storing post data. Redis JSON has been used to store all other entities. Redis Bloom allows us to deduplicate the same entry coming in from different channel or feeds. Full text search is provided by Redis Search. Redis Time Series stores and records the feed update activity as well as the user's reading activity. This allows us to dynamically change the refresh interval of feeds based on how frequently the feeds are updated as well as the time when the user is most active. I encountered three issues during the hackathon. First, the encoding issue with the Redis JSON driver, the unavailability of Redis 6.2.0 in the Docker image, and the limitation of Java APIs for Redis search. Now let's see the application in action. Read is easy. You just have to fire java-jar reread.jar on your command line and the Spring Boot application would start up within a few seconds, the only dependency being that you have the Docker Redis mod image running up. Once the Spring Boot application is up, you can just open localhost 1309 and you will have reread's homepage, which immediately loads an aggregated timeline from all and uses the list view by default. These time series or the timelines are stored as sorted members in the Redis cache. You have the ability to choose between different views such as cards, masonry, title only, or the magazine view. ReRead does not provide an infinite scroll by default, just to ensure that you have control over when you want to load new feeds, and thus we have a load more button. Another important feature of ReRead is that it extracts the main technical line, the first line of each story, as well as the main image for each of the entries that it indexes. When the feeds are crawled and then posts are read from the RSS feed, we index these entries into the search engine, as well as we maintain them in a Redis time series database that allows and provides us the feed interval of each of these feeds as to when they are posting. This allows dynamic refresh rates for each feed. A feed being posted every day is refreshed within 5 minutes. A feed that is posted once a month may be refreshed once a day. Feeds can be categorized inside a folder, or they can be individual feeds at the top. If I have the ability to view an aggregated timeline of each folder, I have the ability to export an OPML as I desire. I can create new folders, I can bookmark entries that I want to. Star serves as the place where I can store all the entries that are my favorite. Bookmarks is the place where I store the entries that I want to read later. I can sort the timeline based on their recency, either it's the newest first or an oldest first. I have the ability to view all the items or filter them by unread and read only. I also have the ability to mark all these entries as read. And I have the ability to mark all these entries and refresh all the feeds wherever I am. We use Redis search to bring out the text search results. For example, there are 4 posts that where Canada is mentioned. I can also search for a word like 500px. Full text search indexing is available courtesy Redis. Let's see if I would want to add a new site. I'll go to the add site thing, I'll paste the URL that I want to, and I'll click discover. It shows me that there's one feed available and I can choose the folder where I would want to add it. I'll just say add. The feed has no feed post for now. This is because the feed has been pushed for crawling to the backend. The server would refresh it in a while. It takes time to extract each important image as well as the text content from the feed and clear it up of all noise. In the meanwhile, let's go back and see what is available to us in Redis. So if I go and see here, I have these images, I'll start bookmarking some of them. Now, if I go to my bookmarks list, I can see that I have these three entries which have been bookmarked by me, and they're available in the order of time. Similarly, this shows the post that I have started. I also have the ability to view activity, which shows me about how I have read the various posts. I can also see the posts that have been starred or the posts that have been bookmarked. The only reason, as I mentioned before, to keep a track of the posts that are being read by the user is to change the frequency of updates as to when the user is active on the system, rather than making sure that we keep polling again and again. And last but not the least, we also have a functionality to import an OPML, which I won't be able to demo as it takes a lot of time to import a file. Thank you.